One of New Zealand's most charismatic animals would have to be that big green flightless parrot, the kakapo. Plagued by predator problems and needing a boost to their love life, kakapo are kept under strict surveillance on protected offshore islands. Unfortunately, that means it's tricky to get the chance to meet one.
The kakapo has many facets to it. It's a very ancient element of our fauna on the more scientific level. It's a very attractive and appealing animal, being a big, fluffy, soft, friendly parrot. And it's a rare New Zealander. No one else in the world has a kakapo or anything that vaguely resembles a kakapo. It's the only flightless parrot, the only nocturnal parrot and so on. It's just a way out parrot. It has a lek mating system. It's the only parrot, the only New Zealand bird. It's the only flightless bird to have a lek mating system. A lek mating system, by the way, is where the males, they don't form pair bonds with females, but instead they establish traditional mating grounds. And the females go there purely for mating purposes. They select a male. It's a bit like a supermarket for males. The females go there to select a mate. They mate, maybe just for one night, and they every 5 years, and they go back to their little home territory, home range, and make their nest, and they lay, and the males know nothing about the babies or the eggs.
Believe it or not, these immaculate looking tracks are not made by dock workers, but by industrious male kakapo who put them all in place just before the breeding season to lure the females up to his bowl, which is of course where he booms.
It sounds like the sound produced when you blow across the top of a big bottle or a jar or something like that. It's sort of foghorn material.
So this is Nog's bowl, and this is probably one of the best looking bowls on the islands. So you can see how it's quite deep, and he'll settle himself in there for 8 hours a night easily and just boom away quite contently.
For the whole 8 hours?
For the whole 8 hours,
wow.
Yeah.
And so being up here in this high spot with quite a pronounced bowl, quite a deep bowl,
yep.
Does he pull in more girls?
He's right sort of smack bang in the middle of quite a few females, so when they do start to think about it, they'll probably gravitate up here, yeah, definitely,
yeah.
And he does get good coverage, and I guess the acoustics are definitely improved because of the bowl. It's a really deep resonant sound. You don't really feel it. You don't really hear it so much as feel it.
Yeah.
You just become aware of it. But I've been up on the tops a couple of nights, and it's quite an amazing noise. It's just solid bass. It's just quite amazing. It's like nothing you've ever heard before.
Wow. We've been lucky enough to meet Sirocco, who's a special kind of kakapo because he's been hand-raised, so he's almost more human than he is parrot. But being so close and personal with him gives us the chance to see what an incredible living taonga this native bird is.